What is up, everybody? It is your boy Nakari, and look, we're gonna get right into it with this little video. And yeah, this video is titled "How Strong Is Death from Now Soul Eater." I gotta say, Soul Eater is one of my top 10, if not top 5, favorite animes of all time. And I say that because the animation is slick, art style is really simplistic but also very dramatic at times, and I just enjoy the weapon system. I love the Meisters, I love the weapons, I love the transformations, I love everything about it. Even in the acting scenes are very creative. Anyway, we're gonna get it. This is not a review on fucking Soul Eater, but which will be coming soon anyway. Anyway, let's get into it. Okay, where do I start? Well, Death's true power has always been a mystery in the series. Like, when I say a mystery, I mean, like, bro, it's borderline, like, almost ambiguous, almost on purpose. Because he's a little bit more watered down than traditional death gods go in anime and in general. It's like this, right? How do I put this? So, in the anime, spoilers, by the way, obviously. In the anime, Lord Death is kind of, like, sealed and, like, fuse his soul to his own city, so he literally can't leave the city in any capacity. He can't go anywhere, and he did that, I don't know why, I guess to protect the people of Death City or whatever or not, or even, I don't know why he did what he did, but obviously there was reason for it. And 800 years ago, he was a freaking beast in the streets. Like, his zoo was not to be fucked with. Like, Medusa's sister, bro, she was terrified, like, legit ran from Death himself. I don't know how the fuck you get away from Death, but you know, I don't know. I don't stress that kind of detail. How the fuck you run from Death, bro? That's kind of retarded. Anyway, and let's not forget that the dude literally ripped off the Kishin, the full Kishin skin, ripped it off, and literally sealed him in a bag of his own skin. He said, "Alright, this nigga playing with me." So he ripped old boy's skin off and put him in back inside of it in bag form. That is some metal ass shit, and it's a little bit hardcore, not gonna lie, but you know, Death back in the day was a pretty scary guy, as you can see from the picture being shown in front of you. But it's like, oh boy was not playing, okay? Like, had Arachne scared, the literal mother of all weapons. So like, I don't know what to say to that. Just like, damn, that's some hardcore shit. If you put fear in the woman who literally created the weapons that Meisters use, you feel me? Who created human weapons. So yeah, literally no one fucks, even to date, no one fucks with Lord Death. Nobody fucks with him. And I feel like they kind of downplayed him in the finale of the series. Excuse me, sorry about that. Where they kind of like made him really weak for some fucking reason. And it really irritated me because I'm like, dude, this guy is a beast. And they kind of watered him down with the Kishin shit just so Maka can have her moment. And I felt like that was really fucking retarded. Because in reality, if this man skinned this man alive, he'll do it again. And like, I don't know how the fuck they made that seem like, oh, it was just a one-time thing. And like, he's not at his peak now. Nigga, that was 800 years ago. This man had 800 years of experience. Good, that's BS, man. In my opinion, I feel like Lord Death could easily destroy this man. If not even more than he did before. Because this is a seasoned Lord Death. And I don't want to hear that he got in fuck with his family. Nigga, that's all a facade. Because we already know it. That little goofy voice of his. Nigga, all that shit is just a facade. Because he don't want to, like, scare anybody. But let's be real. The real Lord Death right now will whip this man into shape even now. I don't know why they fucking made this man out to be some kind of nice kind of guy who would never hurt a fly. Yeah, he's a good guy. But, like, come on now. This is Lord Death, right? The man who skinned the Kishin and scared the hell out of Lady Arachne. Ain't no way in hell this man ain't packing some type of heat. And literally, Kishin Hunter, seriously, this man should have annihilated the Kishin. And it showed like they were just trying to find a way to bench this dude. Like, honestly, how do you do that? That's kind of fucked up. I feel like Lord Death kind of holds back like a lot of his power anyway. But that's what the thing with a lot of overpowered characters who aren't the main character. They always got to hold themselves back and like put a crush on themselves. Like, seriously, Lord Death literally gave himself the biggest handicap. Like, he literally sealed himself into his own city. Like, don't know why, but you know, I guess he just wanted to do it. Like, seriously, this is Lord Death we're talking about. Seriously, that was the weirdest fucking plot device ever. Like, why seal your soul to the city? Like, that's ridiculous. But in my opinion, this dude is powerful. This is literally Lord Death himself, who made Ashura and Kid. Yeah, by the way, manga spoilers for those who didn't know. Technically speaking, Ashura is his son, but we ain't gonna speak on that. I guess it's canon. It's kind of sort of canon in the anime because he does have the same art style, and I guess they probably would have changed it if it wasn't true still. I don't know how that works. Either way, this guy is broken. Seriously. The dude's strong, even now. I know, yeah, again, they water him down, and most of his forthcomings is of his own making. So, yeah, you can do with that what you will. But in my opinion, the dude is a destructive force and should be taken way serious than he is now. But yeah, this was just a small little video. Just a little discussion of how powerful I think Lord Death is and how strong he really is. So yeah, hopefully you enjoyed it. Like, comment, subscribe, do all that good stuff. And hopefully you guys like this video. I have another video coming in a few days. It's very interesting and very different from my norm. It's a little challenge that people do and I've been doing under the scenes. But yeah, anyway, see y'all later. And it's been real, guys. I don't know how else to end it, but yeah, bye.